There are certain countries where they're being robbed of their language. As a result of being robbed of their language, they're also being robbed of a huge part of their culture. Many people use their language as an essential part of their identity. For example, my mom would always tell me how important it was to learn to speak Spanish so I could keep close to my Mexican roots. This is because language is a tool that connects people of that culture. The United States is not one of those countries that is being robbed of their language or their culture. So, if the US is not being robbed of their language or their culture, then who is? Well, there are several African countries that are slowly losing indigenous languages. Keep in mind, Africa is not a country, it is a continent, meaning there are several countries within it. Therefore, several countries in Africa are losing indigenous languages. So, what is causing these losses, you ask? This is happening due to the globalization of Africa. For all intents and purposes, the idea of globalization is a good one. But when it comes to Africa, this seems to be taking place at the expense of their own indigenous languages, which are playing the second fiddle in their activities, particularly in education. Fixing this problem could be the most critical element of Africa's survival in terms of culture, education, and economic development. Countries like Tanzania have avoided this problem by making their own native language the official language of the country. Even though the stripping of languages is a problem in Africa or in African countries, it's not a problem in the United States. There have been several attempts, successful or not, successful and not, to ban bilingual education in various states. There have also been several attempts, all unsuccessful, to make English the official language of the United States. These are not attempts to save a dying language or better the education system. Policies such as these have been pushed for during periods of high immigration. This can be a result of xenophobia, but the author from the reading, Let's Tell the Public the Truth About Bilingual Education, thinks otherwise. According to Stephen Krashen, the push towards these laws can be a result of people being misinformed of what they are actually voting for. Often voters think that they are supporting English when voting against bilingualism. Since Arizona proposition, they have a proposition that is very similar to these cases where they're trying to ban bilingualism, and they did. It's called Proposition 2 or 3, which banned bilingual education, and this was passed back in 2000. But since then, we have seen more than a decade of research that shows otherwise. It shows the advantages of bilingualism and the benefits of bilingual education. Bilingualism and biliteracy come with both cognitive and economic advantages. Bilingual education will help children maintain and develop these advantages.